As you see, I have a new back. I'm gonna be having a mixture of backgrounds. Let me know if you like this background better, like I'm in my room, or if you like when I have the backdrops, because I'm trying to see exactly how I want to incorporate the two. Anywho, hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. So this video will be a first impressions video. Most of the times I try to do a first impressions video, but by the time I get back in the house to show you guys how at the end of the day, I just forget to record the end. But this time, I'm sticking to it. So there's been a lot of hype going around about the new Makeup Forever foundations. If you don't know, the current Makeup Forever foundations that are in stores right now are the last of those particular foundations. They basically reformulate the new foundations, and the ones that you see now, the regular HD foundations, wherever you see it at in stores, those are the complete last of that particular formula. Now, for me personally, my personal experience with the Makeup Forever HD, that one that's in stores now, they don't really have my shade. I'm between 173 and 177. 175 is too red for me. 175 is red. 173 is yellow, as well as 177. So I have to mix 173 and 177, but I ain't got time to do all that, so I don't do it. Now, I do have a Makeup Forever Pro membership for, you know, pro makeup artists. So I got an email and they was having a preview of the Makeup Forever foundations, as well as if you buy 5 bottles, I believe everything was 50% off for the pros only. Good thing for being a pro artist, because that discount is wonders. The new Makeup Forever HD foundation is supposed to take, it's called the Makeup Forever Ultra HD foundation. It's going to take basically the place of the old formulas. Now, I can tell you, I believe there's a whole lot of shades. There's like 48 shades, if I'm not mistaken. I read that online, don't quote me. But a lot of the old shades from Makeup Forever, from the original HDs, some of them will be discontinued. And there will be new added shades. Now, remember when I told you I have to mix 173 and 177 to get my perfect shade? Well, a lot of the shades now that they have, they have a mixture of two. So, for example, there's two shades for 173 now. I have the ones here. I bought two for myself. I have two for myself. The same exact packaging as the old foundations. If you see on the box, this one says 173. So this is the original 173, but this is the second shade to 173, and it's the new foundation. This is the new shade that they added. So if you, when you ever go to see your foundation, if you see your color, this is the old one. Well, they reformulate it, but the ones that doesn't have like the number on top, like 173, 177, 120, that means this is the new shade. The reason why I did too, because I liked it, the original 173. That was here. I like how it looked on me, but I'm a little bit tanned, and the shade that's high in 170 is too light for me, as well as the one next to it, 175, is too red, and 177 will be too dark for me. So since they have one shade just a little bit different mix from this, I believe that's fine for me. I can always mix this two if anything. And on top of that, I am a little bit tan right now, so I thought, okay, that'll work. And when I swatched this in store, I actually like these formula better than the old foundation. So that's why I spent my discount. It came out to $21. But that's only if you was a pro, and that's only for one day only. They had the 50% off. If you are a Pro Makeup Forever member, your discount when you get this will be 40% off. But if you are a regular consumer, you will be paying $43, because that's the original price of the foundation. And to tell you guys, this foundation will not be in stores, Sephora in them, until like July, the second week of July, around that area. Like the end of the first week of July, like, yeah, second week of July, that's when this will be in stores for you guys, if you go to Sephora. When I got it from the Makeup Forever boutique, they come with... they come with the sample of the Makeup Forever Primer and Hydration. Little tiny sample. Now, out of the box, the foundation definitely looks different from the other one. I mean, it's not much of a difference. This foundation just has the silver topping. So, it looks like this. You see how this one says 173? This means this formula is This shade is similar to the old 173, or it is the old 173. And this one is still 173, but this is the new shade that's connected to 173. Now, they're not much of a difference, but it's definitely is a little bit of a difference in here. Just a little tiny bit. So I already already prepped my skin with all of my moisturizers and stuff. All I gotta do is prime my face. One side I'm gonna do using a beauty blender, and the other side I'm going to be doing using a brush. I'm only priming my T-zone because you guys know I don't prime the rest of my face because I have really dry skin. But in my T-zone, I'm oily. So I'm going to be using the Makeup Forever Step 1 Primer. And this is the matte one. Okay, so I'm going to try first the 173, the actual 173. And we can see how that goes. Like I mentioned before, I am a little bit tanned. So we'll see how this is. So yeah, this would be like my... This would be like my winter color, but I'm just going to be applying the one that's like a little bit richer. So it's just the same color. It's not dark, but it's more rich, more saturated, in my opinion, in the undertone. I'm using is a Morphe 439 brush. I don't know if you can tell, but the brush deposited the color different from the sponge. The sponge gave it a little bit more coverage. Can you see the difference of color from this side compared to this side? You see how it's more packed on, and then the brush gave it like a natural kind of finish. So I'm gonna build up the coverage with this now. Now I can tell you right off the back, I like this foundation. You guys can't tell. You guys can't tell, but this foundation is my actual skin color. Now, I have problems with foundation because I am a golden undertone. I'm not yellow. I'm like a golden, think of mustard undertone. I'm not olive. I'm a golden undertone. And this foundation here hits it on the nail. Like, this foundation is my color. And I'm very impressed with them. And I'm really glad they made the extension of that color. And they did that with a lot of other foundations. So I'm going to go ahead and do the rest of my makeup. And I'm going to be right back. And just to let you know right now, it is 10:54. Okay, you guys. So I did my whole entire face. If you guys want to know, under my eyes, I used the Makeup Forever Waterproof Concealer in shade 10, shade 12. And I also used my Kevin Kwan for my under eye highlight. Am I crooked? Yeah. To contour, I use this La Grace Cosmetics Powder Perfect in shade 45. You would have thought it's my skin color, but it oxidizes, so it's really dark. So I use it to contour. And to highlight, I use this powder from Makeup Forever that I also bought. It's called Compact Shine On, and it gives you this really, really nice glow all over the face. Foundation though? So far, I'm like really in love with this foundation. I love this formula better, and I like this color better than the last color. Yeah, it's really, really nice on the skin. I guess I'll give you a little close up. This is how my skin look. My under eyes look extremely light for some reason on camera, but I promise you it's not. But this is how my skin looks. But yeah, I have to work today, so I have to be at work at 2 o'clock. Right now, it is 11:40, and I started doing this like around 10:54, I told you guys. I'm working with me. I'm able to record during my lunchtime to show you guys an update on my face. If not, I will try to include some pictures, and I will come back to you later on tonight when I get off work, which I get off at 10 o'clock. So around 11 o'clock, I will give you an update on this foundation. In this video, I will insert a quick little video that I took on my iPhone of me, like, during my lunch break around 5 o'clock, like 5:30. Between 5 and 5:30, I took a video on my phone, so it's not that good of a quality, but you guys can see I definitely zoomed in. Okay, you guys, so I am back. It is now 12:26 p.m. a.m. Well, it's Sunday now. I just want to give you my final review on this foundation, my final and last update for the night. If you guys don't remember, I have this foundation on since around 10-something this morning, 10:54 this morning. And yeah, and I went to work and everything. Now, I did not touch up the foundation at all. The only thing I touched up was the highlighter. And I did this at work. I switched the highlighter and I put the Makeup Forever Duo. And this is number 2. Other than that, I didn't touch up anything else at all around my face area. And if you can tell, like now, I'm having this little tiny bit of cracking. Right here, you know, separation of foundation. Typical. But that's about it. It's just around this area here around that particular time. And there's the overview of my foundation. Now, this is how the forehead look. I don't know if you can tell, but I am budging a little bit of oil here. Can you see me? Like, I can literally slide away the product. Like, I can slide. And just to let you guys know, I did not powder my forehead area and I did not powder my jaw area because that's the area that I wanted to test how the foundation is without powder. So I powdered was underneath my eye as well as where I put the highlight and contour. But yeah, and then like I said before, around the mouth area, I'm definitely getting some cracking, but that's typical foundation. I mean, the coverage, it definitely held up good though, as you can see. Typical underneath the eye, like it's the end of the day, so end of the day, the eyes will start to crease. Like, it still is lightweight on the skin, like, and it still looks good. Like, I can, all I have to do is just put a little bit of powder underneath my eyes and then put a little powder on my forehead and I'm still good to go. Watch. So yeah, you guys, I approve of this foundation. Like, personally, here's the pros of this foundation. There is a better range. If you was in between shades of the old foundation, they have your shade. They have more coverage than the old formula. To me, it lasts way longer than the old formula, as you can see here. And it didn't even oxidize, but it still looks like me, as you can see. I hope you guys enjoy my review. The new Makeup Forever shades will be out in Sephora around the second week of July. Remember, they are discontinuing the old formula, so if you do like the old formula, I suggest you stock up on it now, because after the new ones come out, they will no longer sell it anymore. But hey, you might like this better instead. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. And if you guys can't wait for the new formula, let me know down below. And like always, I'll see you guys in my next video. Until next time.